If your Windows PC seems to have a mind of its own, you may not be imagining it. Hackers love quiet access that goes completely unnoticed. So I'm gonna show you three quick checks that anyone can run to spot it. Keep watching because you definitely don't wanna miss this. So a lot of people think that if they get hacked, it will be pretty obvious. But in reality, most hacks stay quiet in the background and hope that you never notice. The good part is that you do not need to be an expert. Windows already gives you a few tools to see what's really going on behind the scenes, but you do need to know where to look. In case you're new here, this is VPN Mentor, and we help you stay safe online without turning it into a full-time job. So if you find these videos useful, be sure to tap the like button and subscribe to see our future uploads. Now, here's the part that most people forget. Hackers aren't trying to stand out. They hide inside normal-looking apps and background processes, and sometimes even create their own user accounts on your PC. And they're counting on you never checking any of this. And if someone already has your IP address, your device becomes an easier target, especially on public Wi-Fi. So before we jump into the specific steps, it helps to know what we're up against. Which brings us to step one, check who your PC is actually talking to. If something suspicious is running, this is one of the easiest ways to catch it. But before we do anything, make sure you close all of your browsers, Chrome, Edge, everything. This gives you a clean baseline so you only see the important stuff. Now open the Start menu and search for Command Prompt. Right-click it and choose Run as Administrator. You're gonna want full access for this part. Inside the window, type this command, netstat-ano, and press Enter. And once you do that, you'll see a list of active connections on your PC. You can ignore most of it and focus on two things, the foreign address column and the state column. Foreign address shows where your PC is connected. State shows if that connection is active. So if you see an IP address that you do not recognize, this is your first sign to look a little bit closer. Copy that IP and paste it into any online IP lookup tool, and you'll be able to see the country and the owner of that server. And if it belongs to something familiar like Microsoft or Cloudflare, you're probably fine. But a random server in a random country that you never interact with, well, that deserves a bit more attention. Now look at the last column, the PID. That is the process making the connection itself. Open Task Manager and go to the Details tab. Find that PID in the list, and this tells you exactly which app is responsible for that connection. If it is your browser or a trusted app, no problem. But again, if it is something that you have never seen before or something with a very suspicious name, that is definitely a major red flag. And at this point, you can right-click the process and open the file location to see where it is hiding on your system. Again, if it's sitting inside a strange folder or looks clearly out of place, then you may have found something that you were not supposed to find. This is one of the simplest ways to spot hidden malware because even quiet intruders need to talk to a server somewhere. And yes, this works on Windows 10 and Windows 11. Now, the easiest way to dodge all of this is to hide your real IP address so that hackers or basically anyone else can't track you down. And that's exactly what a VPN does. It hides your IP, encrypts your traffic, and makes you a way tougher target, especially on public Wi-Fi. And if you want to try one out, check out our video on the best free VPNs for Windows specifically. I'll link to it down in the description. Step two is to run Windows hidden malware scan. The next check is even easier. We're going to use the built-in Windows tool that most people have never heard of before. It's called the Microsoft Malicious Software Removal Tool. Sounds dramatic, but it is very simple to use. Just open the run box by pressing the Windows key and R at the same time and type MRT and hit enter. You'll see a window pop up, and this is a standalone malware scanner that Windows updates quietly, and it's designed to detect common and dangerous threats. Then click next and you'll see a few scan options. You'll want to choose quick scan, and it checks the places where malware usually hides, and this should only take a few minutes and is a great starting point. If you've noticed serious performance issues or you feel like something is really wrong with your computer, you can run a full scan. Just know that it can take a long time depending on how much you store on your computer. Once the scan finishes, it'll show you the results, and if it finds something, Windows will remove it automatically. And that's probably your sign to follow up with a deeper scan later as well. If it shows a clean result, then that's definitely good news. It means there is no obvious malware hiding in usual spots. This one is simple, fast, and it's built into every modern version of Windows, so running it once in a while is definitely a smart habit to get into. Step three is to look for hidden user accounts. For our last check, we're gonna look at something most people never even think about: user accounts on your PC. If a hacker ever gains access, one of the smartest things they can do is create a new account for themselves as a quiet way back in, even if you change your password later. So let's make sure no one's camping on your system. Open the run box again with the Windows R key and type netpliz and press enter. You'll see a window with every user accounts on your computer, and take a moment to look through this entire list, because you should obviously only see accounts that you recognize. Your own accounts, maybe a family account, or the built-in administrator account. Nothing else. So if you spot a name that you have never seen before, especially one that has admin rights, that is a serious sign of trouble. Some malware creates generic accounts like service user or default user to try and blend in. So if you find something suspicious, select it and remove it immediately. Windows is going to ask you if you also want to delete the data linked to that account, and if you're sure that it does not belong there, remove it completely. Again, this check only takes a few seconds, but it can reveal one of the clearest signs of a compromised PC. If someone created their own way into your system, then this is where you catch them. But just like that, you have done three of the quickest security checks that almost no one ever uses. You checked who your PC is actually talking to, you ran a malware scan that most people don't even know exists, and you made sure that no one has created a secret backdoor entrance into your system. I know these steps might seem really simple, but they can reveal a lot. If something was hiding, there's a good chance that one of these checks will pick it up. And of course, if everything looks normal, then that is great news as well. If you did find something suspicious, don't ignore it. Run a full scan, change your passwords, and take it seriously. But before we finish, here is one final thing to remember. Spotting a problem is good, but preventing one is even better. And again, a VPN hides your IP, encrypts your traffic, and makes you a much harder target, especially on public Wi-Fi. So if you want to try one safely without paying for anything, then check out our videos on the best free VPNs for Windows. We'll link to that up here and some other resources down in the description. But as always, thanks for watching and stay safe out there.